My name is Emmanuel Routier. I'm heading the International Machine-to-Machine Center, so I'm a director of this entity, which is the center of expertise of Orange in the machine area space for the global offer. Okay, so I mean, let's talk about indeed, you know, some elements which are important. So when we talk about customer experience, we can start by talking about, you know, industries. And there are many industries today which have their own processes, you know, and on which, you know, they need to differentiate, they need to improve, and they need to reduce their costs. We need to be more agile. And machine to machine can indeed, you know, bring these kind of improvements, these differentiations. And that's, you know, something where the solution we can provide as a mobile operator, you know, is indeed a solution which has to be in line with, you know, their expectations, because we talk about their own processes. So it's their own core business. So we need to provide the real needed quality of service. And it's what, you know, I mean, we did focus on Orange through specific processes, dedicated units, dedicated elements in the solution we can provide, which are connectivity solutions, and then going a bit beyond with certain partners, certain own subsidiaries that we have, in order to help the customers to add this end-to-end solution, to make the solution, you know, in line with their processes and expectations. So I mean, there are two types, I would say, of industries. So I mean, first of all, you know, machine to machine today, we can say you have traditional machine to machine. It's based on the industrial processes I mentioned earlier. And those are more, I would say, industrial players like Atlas Copco, you know, for compressors. It can be players like, I would say, ELM Leblanc, you know, for boilers. So those guys, you know, are kind of indeed, you know, industrial pioneers in order to improve their processes. And we see now new players coming, which are more closer to B2C, I would say, domains, mm-hmm. like Nespresso or Qualcomm Life, you know, which is a subsidiary of Qualcomm, where basically, you know, they put in place, you know, plugs, which enables to connect multiple, I would say, health devices in order, you know, to aggregate the traffic and provide services to the end customers. So that's the second wave. It's, I would say, a bit further the traditional wave. It's more the consumer wave, where we see growing, actually. But still a lot of to do, you know, on the traditional one, and the grow, I mean, the big one coming with those big players. But I mean, you can talk about also connected devices. You know, TomTom is a good example about, you know, a huge success in terms of connectivity and devices,
with,
you know, spread. Coyote also, you know, for the radar detection or alert, I would say, alert devices, things, you know. Those are, you know, players which are smaller players, but also addressing these consumer solutions. And between these two waves, you have the regulatory-driven wave, which is the e-call, smart metering, road user chargings. And then here, you know, it's, you see players like automotive players. So, I mean, it was great to be part of the M2M World Congress, to be part of the panel and the spreading the word of machine-to-machine and being part of this event, you know. It was indeed, you know, a huge event, to be honest with you. I was really surprised by the number of people attending, the also the experience there, you know, the exchange we can see, and also, you know, I would say the time which is left to networking, but also to exchange, you know, during the different presentation.
Thank you so much, Matt.